Have your attention. We're already a few minutes late, but we have a little bit of a technical difficulty trying to hook Elias's father in tonight. So we're going to go ahead and do our announcements and have a few comments, and we'll have an invitation song, and then a prayer, and hopefully by that time we can get this to work and we can begin some way to communicate the work in Honduras. I know it's something that this congregation is very interested in. We've been supporting that work. There's been a lot of good activity in that work, a lot of prosperous work for God, and I was hoping we could hear from all the various works in Honduras that we've been involved with, and I know some of you have individually been involved with it as well, so we really appreciate that, and hopefully we'll be able to do something here to get started in just a few minutes. I just want to give you a couple of announcements. In terms of our prayer request, let's continue to remember Thelma Ham. She's been taken back to the hospital. I'm assuming that's today because I talked to her and she was going home, but she's home now. Okay, good. So we need to remember her in our prayers. We're doing more tests the last time I spoke with her. Also, please remember Ron Walker's sister, Mary Renfro, who's in rehab and has been tested for COVID and is waiting results. In terms of activities we have coming up, the graduation reception to honor the graduating class of 20 and 21 on Sunday, July 11th, after the 1 p.m. service. If you'd like to contribute toward that, please give your money to one of the elders' wives by July 4th. Also, need to think about turning in our change cans or any checks that you want to make out to the children's home by Sunday, July 11th. July 18th, our services will be at the Jerseyville Church of Christ at 2 p.m. We will not do a 1 o'clock service here. We want to encourage everybody that can to come out to Jerseyville. We're looking forward to worshiping with that congregation on Sunday at 2 p.m. On July 18th. I also want to get you to mark your calendars for Family Day for August 28th. Looking forward to that as well. We have a lot of good activities for that day. And for those young parents that always feel like they're in the classrooms, we are arranging for teachers that day for our young people, so it will not involve any teachers from this congregation to teach our young people on that day, which will allow all of us to participate in the lessons on that day. So that's on August 28th, Saturday, August 28th. Clothing and toys are still needed for the clothing room, and the food pantry this week is chicken bouillon. That concludes the announcements. Let's begin our service with a word of prayer. Father, we're thankful for this day, for the blessings that we have. We're thankful for the opportunity that we have to be engaged in spreading your word, not only in this community, but in places abroad. We're thankful for those that are working so hard in Honduras to teach your word and to convert people, to sow your seed, to see the blessing that comes from that, to see Christians added to our family. We ask, Father, that you continue to bless them in that work. We ask, Father, that you be with all those that are teaching your word, both here and abroad. Pray that they'll continue to have the zeal and the funding they need to continue to spread the borders of your kingdom. We ask, Father, that you be with us as we strive to do your will here. We pray that you'll be with us as we live our everyday lives. We ask that you forgive us when we fail you. Give us strength to serve you. We're thankful for your son that died up on the cross of Calvary that makes all this possible for us, and it's in his name we pray. Amen. Just a brief word before we have an invitation song. Regina and I were talking on the way here tonight. I remember my grandfather standing up quite often on a Wednesday night where he preached. He preached where my brother preaches today. In fact, my brother will be preaching for us on Sunday, but he preached in the same congregation my brother preaches at now, and he would get up and he'd look at the audience, and he would say, I know you all. You know what you need to do to make your life right with Christ. I can't say that I can look at you tonight and say that emphatically, but there was something about that that struck with me, and I've said it many times. He didn't feel like he had to say a lot. He just let the gospel and God's word talk to people who already knew it. And so tonight, if you know there's something you need to correct in your life, if you need to be baptized, to be added to the Lord's church, If you've made a public sin that you need to confess of, or if you just need to go to God in prayer for yourself on your own behalf, if you have any need, we're here to help you in any way that we can. And we'd ask that you come forward as we stand and sing.
We'll sing number 53, At Calvary. We'll have to do this old school, I understand, from the book, unless you know this from memory. We'll do the first and last verses. At number 53, At Calvary. Years I spent in vanity and pride, caring not my Lord was crucified. Knowing not it was for me, he died on Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. Oh, the love that drew salvation's plan. Oh, the grace that brought it down to man. Oh, the mighty gulf that God did span at Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. Be seated, please.
Hable, hermano Manuel, hable, y yo voy a traducir de allá adelante. Hagamos eso, porque no hay otra forma. Aquí lo están esperando la gente, mire. Sorry, guys. Exactly. Déjeme explicarles un poco qué ha pasado, hermano, y usted entonces habla. Y aquí habla y yo lo voy a poner aquí, ¿ok?
Ah, okay, hermano. Me parece bien.
Okay, guys. Thank you so much. I'm so sorry. They are in the gospel meeting right now, 3 days, 8 hours outside from the city. So far, they had 2 baptisms. They travel all the way to Mesapa. This is the place that they just start in January. So they have been, they left home Monday. So they're going to go back tomorrow. So they just finished evangelism, and they were running all the way too. But seems like the link, so they're not able to get admitted. There's 2 reasons maybe. One is because they need to download the app in their tablet or their cell phones. So we try in the other way, but there's no way. We put code and password, and it's still the same way. So far we try. So Manuel is going to be speaking right now, so I will be translated for you. Okay? Also, Manuel is trying to show me some slides that he worked to show this presentation for you guys. We're going to go ahead and talk with Manuel right now. Okay, hermano, listo. Aquí están escuchándolo. Yo voy a decir lo que usted diga. Tiene 8 minutos.
Okay. Mi nombre Manuel Edgardo Pérez Vázquez.
My name is Manuel Pérez Vázquez.
Predicador y evangelista de la Iglesia de Cristo en la colonia San Miguel Tegucigalpa. Y Agua Dulce Las Cañadas.
Preacher and evangelism from La Cañada and also San Miguel Church of Christ in Tegucigalpa and Valley of the Angels too.
Mi esposa Sandra Maricela Martínez.
My wife Sandra Maricela Martínez.
Hoy quiero agradecer la oportunidad que me brinda.
Today I want to really appreciate it so far from the bottom of my heart, the time that you are asked me and share this time with you having this presentation.
Por hacerme parte de su equipo de trabajo.
And also to be part in your teamwork as evangelist from West End.
Este apoyo y confianza es de gran valor para mí.
And this trust and support is really, really value and much from my heart. Thank you.
Espero aportar valor a sus proyectos y metas para seguir siendo parte del gran equipo de trabajo en la obra del Señor.
I hope me as an evangelist, I can fulfill your expectation in your teamwork as a missionary from West End in the area here in Honduras.
A continuación presentaré un resumen del trabajo realizado durante estos 6 meses.
I will give a resume or a short presentation about the work that I have been doing since January.
Mostraré algunas fotos.
I will show some pictures, but you're not able to see it. Continúa, hermano.
Equipo de trabajo, predicadores.
So, preacher's work.
Hermano Elías Roque.
I have been working with Brother Elías Roque Sr.
Y hermano Robert Brown.
And the brother Robert Brown from Panama.
Evangelismo en la colonia San Miguel Tegucigalpa.
I have been evangelist in San Miguel City. It's in the Tegucigalpa, Honduras.
A pesar de la pandemia y el sectarismo, las personas nos reciben con mucho amor y con mucho agrado.
Even with the pandemic and also the hard religious confidence that people have, I have been having Bible studies with people so far all this time.
Empezamos a tener contacto con las personas.
So we have been in contact with people in every street.
Un mes estudiamos con hermano Rosendo. El resultado fue entregarse al Señor. Fue bautizado. Para el perdón de sus pecados.
There was a guy, his name is Rosendo, and I studied with him a month. After a month, he became a Christian.
Seguimos estudiando con su hija Natalia y fue bautizada.
As we study with him, suffering for an illness, I was studying with his daughter.
Estudiamos con la familia varios meses. Pertenecían al grupo religioso Avance Misionero, hermano Marvin y hermana Kelly, y se bautizaron.
Marvin and Kelly was another couple that they were so faithful in the Pentecostal church, but with several months, we have been with my wife knocking his door, having Bible study, so and they become a Christian, part of the Church of Christ also.
Estudiamos con la hermana Jamie y se bautizó.
With also Jamie, and she was baptized.
Actualmente tenemos muchos contactos de estudios en los diferentes lugares.
Actually, we have several contacts in Bible study as we go on the streets.
Nos involucramos en las diferentes actividades que la iglesia tiene.
As part of evangelism, I also incorporate myself with my wife in several activities in both congregations, San Miguel and La Cañada.
Colaboro en las predicaciones días jueves y a veces domingos.
A church like San Miguel, almost 20 years old, they have 5 services a week. So I help on Thursday to speak to them, and Sundays, some Sundays too.
Trabajamos con los hermanos recién convertidos acerca del crecimiento espiritual.
We have a plan to continue those people that they're being baptized, having them some newcomers classes too, that myself is helping them.
Colaboramos con los hermanos a empacar bolsas de comida para los hermanos. Es una actividad de la iglesia.
So also, San Miguel, leaders like in San Miguel Church, we help them packing some meals that some congregation have been donated to families and churches. So we help them to pack several bags of meals.
Evangelismo en Agua Dulce, Las Cañadas.
Now we're going to pass to Valle de Angels, Agua Dulce, La Cañada, another congregation.
Estamos trabajando con familias.
We have been working with several families in this area also.
No tenemos bautismos, pero creemos que la obra en el futuro, Dios es el que añade a sus miembros a su iglesia.
We haven't had any fruits yet in this area, but so far we're praying and we keep planting the seed, and we know from the Lord in the future we can have harvest from the truth.
Si trabajamos con perseverancia.
If we work with perseverance.
Él es Danilo y Heidi. Ellos han dicho que por falta de recursos económicos no se han casado, pero están visitando a la iglesia. Es una familia con la que estamos trabajando.
I have a couple. His name is Danilo and Heidi. And for economic situation, they haven't married yet. But so far, they have been coming to church and get it in somehow coming by several weeks so far, getting into the congregation so we can, in the future, they can be strong in their decision and the next step, become a Christian after they marry.
Envía Claudia mientras las hermanas dan clase a los niños y comparten una comida. Es buen momento para hablarles de Cristo a las madres de los niños.
We have a village of poor people. They call Via Claudia. So San Miguel pack some meals, and they spend a Saturday, almost all Saturday, with the kids. They'll play. And when they're playing, the parents are around. So I, myself, he said, get in contact with parents. So we study in the same time, so the kids are being fed.
Hacemos cultos hogareños.
We also incorporate work in Valle de Angels as worship homes, divos homes.
De la mejor manera, vamos a buscar a los hermanos.
We also, we're trying to incorporate more members into this work as evangelism.
Visitamos a los hermanos.
We visit also members of the congregation when they're sick.
A veces predico miércoles o domingo en la congregación de Agua Dulce Las Cañadas, la oportunidad que me da el predicador, hermano Robert, en ese lugar.
Brother Robert, sometimes he left me too, and I really appreciated the time that speaking on Wednesdays or Sundays. It depends also how the work is going through every week.
Otras actividades en la obra de Dios.
Another activities that we have been doing to our God.
Viajamos a Mogote, Sulaco y Oro.
We have been traveling in a new place. It's called Sulaco Yoro.
Misión con nuestro hermano Elías, su esposa Ruth, y su hijo Samuel, y mi esposa.
We have been traveling with Elías Sr., his wife, and his son Samuel to this area.
Todos evangelizamos. El resultado fue 8 bautismos.
As a evangelism team, all the preachers, so we have been having fruit, 8 baptisms in total in this area.
Con mi esposa hemos viajado 3 domingos para apoyar la iglesia en los servicios de adoración, un viaje de 5 horas.
We have been helping as this place is developing, so traveling is 5 hours. So I have been going 3 Sundays so far to this area with my wife.
Reunión de predicadores en Mesapa, departamento de Atlántida. Días de evangelismo.
Preacher meetings that we have every 3 months. So far, right now, we are in Mesapa. So we evangelists, we have 2 days of evangelism.
Conclusión.
In conclusion,
valorar una vez más el alto grado de apoyo económico para suplir nuestras necesidades básicas.
I really value all the help that you have been giving me, especially to my wife and me, to do this work in these areas.
Seguiremos trabajando con mayor amor por Dios.
We will continue working for the love of our God.
Por su obra.
For his work.
Por los resultados que Dios da.
And for the results that he is able to give us when we labor.
Y para que la iglesia de Cristo crezca espiritualmente.
And also to cooperate it to the Church of Christ, maybe growing more and more in this area.
Primera de Corintios, capítulo 15, versículo 58.
1 Corinthians 15, 58 says,
así que, hermanos míos, amados,
love and brethren,
estad firmes y constantes,
be faithful and firm,
creciendo en la obra del Señor siempre,
growing in the Lord, in the work of the Lord always,
sabiendo que vuestro trabajo en el Señor no es en vano.
Knowing that your work is not in vain in the Lord.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much. Amen. Déjeme explicar un momento. Okay, so Manuel is already. So let me say this. San Miguel is the church that I grew. Okay, it's my dad's congregation. 16 to 18, 20 years old already, this congregation. La Cañada was a place that I was preaching with my sister too when I married, so I moved here. So this area is Robert is preaching. So West End have been having this great opportunity too that invests in Honduras. So that's why we have him as evangelist helping these 2 congregations. But something happened in the beginning of this year, after the pandemic, a member from here, her name is Sandra, tell us about his mom. So his mom lived in Atlantida. It's like 8 hours from San Miguel Church, the city. So my dad traveled with Manuel and Robert, and they baptized one person, her mom, a member from here, his mom in Honduras. So this woman was telling the preachers, my dad, Robert, and Manuel, what are we going to do now? So there's no Church of Christ here. My dad asked her and says, would you like to have worship here? Yeah, you can. I would like you. I want to see you again. Don't leave me alone like this. So my dad had been traveling there eight hours all the time. And then we contact a preacher like 2 hours and a half from that area. So Alban, with some projects that we have with my wife and some several members, he has support until December for this area. Alban, he knows that his support is going to end in December. Okay, so when that happened, another person that, and this is not a story, is that this person raised me, teaching me classes as a kid, contact my dad and say, I live in a new community and these people are really grieving about the Church of Christ doctrine. I have been teaching them. Some of them want me to make worship, and you know, Brother Elias, that's my dad email, you know. He said, I can't. I told him, Church of Christ, women cannot be leading service. So I want some preachers to come here. I have several young people also that want to become Christians. So my dad, with all this situation that he failed, my mom with problem with situation, my family, Manuel, Rover, they went to the area and they baptized 8 people in 2 days. So they came back. So the lady says, let's start the service in my home. So they have been traveling. So far, 2 new areas, they have been developing as a Church of Christ. So that's what Manuel is explaining. So you can have some point of imagination why he says Sulaco, Atlántida, Cañada, San Miguel, because it's 4 areas right now. And that's what he is explaining. So my dad is going to be speaking for 7 minutes now, okay? So after this explanation. Ya le expliqué a ellos, papá, de las áreas que trabajamos, ¿verdad? Así que pasa usted ahora. 7 minutos. 7.
Bueno, primeramente agradecerle a Dios y a ustedes por darnos esta oportunidad de poder explicar la obra que se hace en Honduras.
First, I really appreciated my God and all the members from West End to have this great opportunity to have a presentation of the work and the labor that we have been doing here so far in Honduras.
Ya algunos hermanos que están en West End me conocen.
So I know that some members from West End maybe know me.
Para mí fue una sorpresa cuando el hermano Keith decide ayudar al hermano Manuel.
Mm-hmm. For me, it's really impressed how brothers like Brother Keith went to Honduras and worked side to side with Manuel too as evangelist.
Quiero decirles que realmente ha sido una gran decisión.
Thank you, and it has been a great decision, and I appreciated that you help Honduras, helping to Manuel.
Y quiero informarles de que sí, el hombre que se dedica a evangelizar.
And I want to tell you that the man who dedicates himself to evangelists.
Y una iglesia que tiene su propio evangelista.
And a church that has its own evangelist.
Es un buen resultado para una congregación.
It's a great result for a congregation to have one.
So nosotros far, ahorita en la pandemia hemos perdido muchos miembros mayores.
As I mentioned in San Miguel, we have been, during the pandemic, we lost several members.
Y algunos miembros dejaron de ir por temor al COVID.
And also some members, they don't even come to service for being afraid of COVID.
Pero el trabajo que el hermano ha hecho excelentemente ha suplido entre 4 miembros.
But so far, Manuel has been helping us so much, and dedicating himself for his mission and helping us so much in San Miguel.
Y pensamos que el trabajo que hace va a surgir más personas para la iglesia.
As we know that his work, God will continue to increase more and more everything he does for his kingdom.
Estas son nuestras oraciones.
Those are our prayers, always over them.
Quiero agradecerles mucho por mirar hacia Honduras y apoyar estas obras.
Thank you very much for seeing Honduras as a place that you can help.
Son oraciones que constantemente las hacemos.
And that's our constantly prayers that God can help us to do his will.
Y como decía el hermano, somos un equipo en Estados Unidos, Honduras.
As the brother Manuel mentioned, you guys and us, we are one team in this kingdom.
Y ese es una enorme bendición para que el reino pueda crecer más.
And this is a great blessing from above that the kingdom can grow more and more.
Muchas gracias, hermano, y que Dios le bendiga.
Thank you very much, brother, and God bless you. So that's what he says. Hermano Robert, tiene 8 minutos, hermano, o más. Ocho minutos, después preguntas y respuestas.
Okay.
Now, brother Robert Brown. His name is Robert Brown because he born in Panama, in an island in Panama. So, you know, Panamanians have some American names too. So his name is Robert Brown. But he looked very Panamanian. So, so entonces, estaba explicando por qué se llama usted hermano Robert Brown. No es que es un gringo, sino un hermano de Panamá.
Okay.
Bien, hermano, puede conversar.
Que la paz y el amor esté con nuestros hermanos allí.
The peace and the love of God be with you, brothers, he says.
Estoy muy contento de saber que hoy se han querido comunicar con nosotros.
I'm very thankful and really happy that you guys want to contact us to talk about Honduras.
Y eso indica para nosotros una conexión de equipo de trabajo para la obra del Señor.
This made me think a lot that we are connecting and we are one team in this kingdom to the Lord.
En cuanto a la obra en Las Cañadas, Valle de Ángeles.
So my work in Las Cañadas, Valle de Ángeles, and as a preacher.
La iglesia en ese lugar nos sentimos muy gozoso cuando supimos que Manuel iba a ser parte de ser evangelista de esa congregación.
We were so happy and rejoiced in La Cañada that we knew and the information about having Manuel as evangelist.
Hay mucho, pero mucho trabajo que hacer en el cuanto al evangelismo en ese lugar.
There is a lot of work to do, to be done as evangelist. And all the congregation cooperating to door knocking and gospel meetings in this area.
Con nuestro hermano luchamos contra las denominaciones y la inmoralidad en esa comunidad.
There's two things that we battle every time with Manuel, with the society, is the big false doctrine around us and the fornication. People that are living in fornication, no marry. It's a big cycle of society problems.
Y mientras estamos allí con el hermano, nuestro equipo, hacemos un buen equipo para enseñar el evangelio a cada uno de ellos.
As a team, we go forward and teach them how's the value of life, the value of morals in the sight of the Lord, and helping them in some way to become a Christian and follow Christ.
El hermano junto hemos creado métodos evangelísticos.
As my brother Manuel and me, we have been having several ways to create ways to door knocking or getting to people to have Bible studies.
Para así ser más efectivo el trabajo.
To be more effective as we go.
Hasta el momento no hemos tenido conversión.
As the moment we haven't have any fruit.
Pero estamos seguros que tenemos mucha familia que esperamos en Dios. Ellos aceptarán el evangelio de Cristo.
But we have several families in contact that we know with prayers in the future there will be fruits from that labor.
Tenemos mucha familia que predicar.
We have a lot of families that we preach and more families that they need to be preached.
Y ellos están en nuestras manos.
And they are in our hands, means we are in contact with them.
Así que el trabajo que estamos haciendo es muy bueno.
So the work we have been doing so far seems like it's doing well.
Y efectivamente la iglesia necesita más de obreros para predicar el evangelio.
And as we see the needs, we need more laborers, more workers, evangelists and preachers to be occupied in those areas.
La iglesia estamos muy muy contentos del trabajo que él está haciendo.
So we're very thankful. The church in general is really thankful about having Manuel and his wife also as a team.
Porque para mí solo el trabajo era muy muy grande.
Because only myself was a big work to do.
Y Manuel nos ha ayudado mucho en eso.
And Manuel has been helping us so much in this. ¿Ya, hermano?
¿Aló?
¿Sí?
Y el hermano me colabora y me ayuda con la iglesia en cuanto a canto, evangelismo, predicación, visitas devocionales y evangelismo.
So brother Manuel have been helping me with song, leading songs, prayers, preaching and door knocking with me and helping in several ways.
Y eso es un buen trabajo de equipo que estamos haciendo.
And this is a teamwork that we are incorporating all this together.
No más pedir, hermano, que rogamos sus oraciones por nosotros y la obra en ese lugar.
Please, only thing I will ask is, please keep in us in your prayers for all the labor that we do and everything have been also so far doing it and everything that we'll do too. Please, keep in us in your prayers when you can.
Los apreciamos y gracias.
We appreciate you and thank you. So, questions? Questions and answers? No? Okay. Yeah.
Didn't work quite as we planned, but I hope at least you got some essence of the work that's going on in Honduras. I know Keith and Colette, we've traveled there. Has it been 2 years now? Keith, 3 years? Two or 3 years. And it's interesting. I was thinking as Elias was accommodating the difficulty we had in technology, which a number of the guys have worked to make sure it worked tonight, and then it didn't work. I found it kind of interesting. It didn't work because they were out in another part of the country teaching the gospel. And somehow I almost felt like I probably shouldn't have interrupted their work this evening. When you hear that there's been two congregations planted, there's been eight baptisms, and you know, this isn't like going from here to St. Peter's to Arnold. This is long distances, if you think about it. It's getting up and driving to the Boot Hill to do a Sunday service for somebody. And that gives you an appreciation of the work. I'm really pleased to be a part of that work. And I just want to read something to you before we have our closing prayer. I couldn't help but think about this as we listen to the work tonight. Now you Philippians, Know also that in the beginning of the gospel, when I departed from Macedonia, no church communicated or gave to me with concerning gift and receiving, but you only, to the Philippians. For even in Thessalonica you sent once and again into my necessity. It's not because I desired a gift, but I desire fruit that may abound to your account. This doesn't give us a reason to not try to convert in this area. And it isn't a matter of just sheer pride. It's just a matter of letting you know that the contributions you're giving, collectively through the treasury or sometimes on your own, is helping to spread the gospel in this part of the world. And it is to your account. So we appreciate the support that you've given, and I hope you have at least a very positive feeling about the work that's going on in Honduras. And thanks, Ilias, for accommodating us. With that, we'll have a closing prayer, and Joe's going to lead us in the closing prayer.
I will say that when we were in Honduras, two Americans were assigned two Central American preachers, and we went door to door asking if people wanted to learn about the gospel, and they did the numbers, and it turned out it was about 85% of the people that we asked said yeah, that they would like to hear what we had to say. And I told the two Latin American preachers that in America it's about the exact opposite, probably 10 or 15% would want to hear about the gospel, and they were really shocked. They couldn't believe it. So with that, let's go to our God in prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for all of the many blessings and gifts that you've afforded us through your grace. We ask, Father, that you would forgive us of any unforgiven sins that we may have committed against you in thought, word, and deed. Father, we thank you for Brother Vasquez, Brother Brown, and Brother Roque. We ask, Father, that you would bless them for their faithfulness to you, and that you might give them courage and strength to continue sharing the gospel with those who so desperately need to hear it, Father. And be with their families. Continue, Father, to help their families, to support them in this effort. And help us, Father, to continue to support their efforts as well as share the gospel here in the area that with those who need to hear it as well. We thank you, Father, for your Son, for that great sacrifice that you and he made on that cross for the forgiveness of our sins. And we pray one day, if we're faithful, that we might have a home with you in heaven. This is our prayer. In your Son's holy name we pray. Amen.